Happy debate day. Oh, my guess is that we will have very few people on here tonight. Between the NQC live stream and the debate getting ready to happen in less than an hour, I'm sure people are busy doing other things. So there'll be very few of us on here tonight, but that's okay. They're going to miss a great program. They really are. They're going to miss a dandy, actually. But maybe they can catch it a little bit later, because it's always archived there on Facebook. But going to have, no doubt, a light night tonight between the NQC live stream and the debate. Okay, well, let's do some commercials here. We'll do that first, and then we'll talk about a few things. And then we've got really just a cool program. We're going to do another flashback singing news trivia question thing tonight. And I've really got some cool pieces, and I think you'll like it. Okay, but let's do this. Mark it down, December 7, 8, 9. Excuse me, right here. You need to come and join the Old Time Preachers Quartet, myself, Barry Roland and Deliverance, Bob Sellers, Sacred Harmony, Sherry Taylor, Chelsea Estes, Covenant, Paul Bolin, right there, December 7, 8, 9. Jot down this number. We're going to be in the Smokies. It's going to be great. We're going to, you know what we're going to do. Now, you already know this because everybody that, you know, watches me is on here. We're going to what? We're going to, that's right, we're going to eat. What else are we going to do? That's right, we're going to sing. Then after we sing, what are we going to do? That's right, we're going to eat. Then after we eat, what are we going to do? We're going to do some preaching. And then what are we going to do? We're going to eat. So there you go. Here's the number, 865-278-3681. 865-278-3681. Check it out, okay? We want you there. Christmas camp meeting in the Smokies. We're going to do it quartet style, family group style, trio style, solo style, mixed group style. And we're going to eat. Okay, there you go. So there's that. Don't forget, if you haven't already gotten it, you need to get it. Come on now. Facebook Live with Les Mug, right there. There I am, me and my chubby little face, my glasses, my headphones. There's all the radio gear. Facebook Live with Les, right there. Southern Gospel Music, Memorabilia, Memories in Ministry. And the ministry part's going to be different tonight. Matter of fact, just a lot of things a little bit different tonight. Okay, so go to butlermusicgroup.com, click on the store, and go check it out, okay? While you're there, you can also check out my new single. That's my preacher. And October is Pastor Appreciation Month. October 11th is Pastor Appreciation Day. And go to familymusicgroup.com/contest. And there you can hear the song. If you like it, you can download the song. You can pre-order the CD, which, if the Lord helps us, will be finished tomorrow. I've been a year finishing this thing. I can't finish stuff because of all the other albums I'm producing and working on for other folks. So it's wonderful. It's a blessing. I'm not complaining. But it's a year late in getting out. Oh, my. Anyway, you can pre-order and order the preacher song and all that kind of stuff there. So check that out. familymusicgroup.com/contest. And by the way, enter your pastor into the contest. We're going to just randomly choose a preacher, and that preacher is going to win a $500 gift bag of CDs and DVDs and T-shirts and hats and mugs and cups and glasses and this and that and the other, and it's really cool. And a pair of tickets to the Mike Huckabee TV show in Nashville, and a pair of tickets to the Passion Play just south of Branson, Missouri. And the person who submits their pastor is going to win the same prize. So two $500 value gift bags there. Nice. Nice, boys and girls. You got the entire month of October to do it. familymusicgroup.com/contest. All right. What else we have here? Diamond Awards. Don't forget, I'm very blessed to have a bunch of the folks that I work with nominated for many of these Diamond Awards. So if you see Lisa Williamson or the Williamsons at all in four categories, vote for them if you would. In the bluegrass category, Roger Johnson, Rodney Johnson, Debbie Johnson, Heaven's Mountain Band, any of those names, vote for them. They've got four categories that they've been nominated in the top five. And then we've got Heart to Heart in there for a category, so you got to vote for them. And then somehow or another, I got nominated in the top five for the J.D. Sumner Living Legend Award. The other nominations, that I can explain. My nomination, not so much, but go ahead and vote. Okay, Thursday, two nights, matter of fact, 47 hours and 55 minutes from now, you will see the first of a seven-part series of my interview with Don Reed of the Statler Brothers. Did a video interview with him, and turned out great. It's going to be a seven-part series. The first one is Thursday night, and then after the Thursday night video, I'm coming on with a Facebook Live, and we're going to play the gospel music of the Statler Brothers that we talked about in that very interview. So it's going to be really cool. Mark it down. Thursday night, 7 Central, 8 Eastern. I'm going to watch that video, and then I'll be going on Facebook Live. We're going to have a good time there. And Dollywood, October 28th. Okay, the Old Time Preachers Quartet. We'll be at Dollywood on October 28th. We were originally booked in the big auditorium, the big one, the 2,000-seat one. Boy, were we honored to be asked to do that. Wow. But COVID messed that up, and the date and everything. So everything's changed. Now we're going to be at one of the outdoor theaters, and it's instead of October 20, whatever it was, it's now October 28th. So, but we're honored, man. We're going to go to Dollywood and tell them about Jesus. We're going to sing about the book, the blood, the blessed hope, and just do what we do. Probably get some preaching in there, and it's what we do. And so that's whether we're in a church or Dollywood, we do the exact same thing. You get four preachers together that want to tell people about Jesus. It just comes out the way it comes out. And so if you like that kind of thing, meet us at Dollywood on October 28th. Okay. Let's see who's on with us, and then we'll get started. Let's see what we got going on here. There's my aunt, Aunt Sue, Gene Thorne. He's on there. I think Gene was the first one. Beat my Aunt Sue this time, Gene. Way to go. Roger Cruz, good to see you, sir. Paul Hyde, how you doing, Redemption's Promise? Good to see you. Roger Cruz from Southern Illinois. Stephen Gorley, I believe is how you might say that name. Good to see you. Patty Graham from Ho-Ha-Ho. Good evening, Brother Les. Jimmy Hayes, how you doing? God is good. Amen. Let's see what Chuck Robbins is saying. Good evening, Les, at my daughter's home in Monk's Corner, South Carolina. Monk's Corner, I guess. Okay. Heading to NQC Fall Festival in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee on Thursday, then back home to Michigan on Sunday. Has anybody been to, just out of curiosity, has anybody been to the NQC Fall Festival thing that they're doing instead of the Quartet Convention this year? Has anybody been there? If so, tell me how it's been. This is the first year I've missed in almost 30 years, and I think in the last 42 years I've missed like 3 years. But we couldn't go in and set up our booths and all that, and I host all the showcases, the morning showcases, and they did away with all those, so there was no reason for me to be there to work, either for my own company, because we couldn't put a booth up, or for the showcases, et cetera, et cetera. So here I sit, doing Facebook Live with you, and mixing records here in Nashville all week instead, and being with my wife instead. I got to give a thumbs up to that. So, let's see. So, I just wondered, anybody been to NQC? Just let me know if you have. Vic, how you doing, Vic? Oh, Chicago Vic. Vic Zabelka. Good to see you, sir. Okay, let's see. What was I going to say? Oh, did anybody purchase the NQC stream? Just out of curiosity, did you purchase the NQC stream? And if so, how's that been? Type in there and let me know what's going on. Going up one evening to spend some time with our buddy. Oh, yeah. Oh, Nick. Who's Dad Ken? You bet. You bet, Paul. Tell Nicholas I said hello. All right, so let's do what we're going to do here. So tonight we're going to do another flashback card trivia game contest from the mid-90s. It's about 25-year-old pack of trivia cards from the Singing News. And I'm just going through them one at a time. And we won't do this every night now for the next 6 months or something, but we've done a couple. I might do one or two more, then I'll be on to other things for our Facebook Live. But, so here's the first question. Let's see how you all do here. This is so easy. Who organized the Statesmen? This is so easy. Hovey Lister, R.W. Blackwood, J.D. Sumner, Wally Fowler. This is so easy. And when was it? 1938, 48, or 58? This is so easy. I might have said that before. Who's going to be the first one? I just lobbed you a softball. Come on, Paul Hyde. Knock it out of the park. I know you know all this. Come on now. And then I'm going to play a song by the Statesmen Quartet from Hotlanta, Georgia. Who did it? Who started the Statesmen? Was it J.D. Sumner? Was it Wally Fowler? Was it Wally Fowler? Hovey Lister? Thank you, Paul. I didn't want to be here all night with that. So easy. Hovey Lister started them. Okay, Paul, tell him the year. 1938. Mr. Hyde, you, sir, are wrong. Was it 38, 48, or 58? I want to give you one more guess, Paul. Come on now. If it wasn't 38, it was. No, Roger, wasn't 38. Tell you what, I'm going to play something off of this here record right here. That's right, Paul, 1948. Hovey Lister and the Statesmen Quartet, Happy Land. I am going to play gospel music's first rap. Sure enough, the urban music crew thought that they started rap. No, they didn't. Right here's the first rap. The Statesman, Big Chief.
Atrocity, they still him out of bondage. He said it freely and put Pharaoh's evil hand. He comes in time, picked him on the journey, and lead him to the promised land.
Statesmen made the plans, so comfort molded by the hands and molded from old Pharaoh's hand. But molded for the way to get out, for any man who began to rouse, and Lord, oh, bring the way to get to me. My Lord said, son, go down that bottle, molded him, then he cried to God, return the snake, and bring him in, let's sing. And he cried again, he went along the way, but the Lord said, seize him by the way, and
he said,
let him come through for a body.
God wants to lead, they cheered him out upon me. He said he freed him from Pharaoh's evil hand. He promised to die and kept him on the journey and lead him through the promised land.
And Lord, when molded out that power, I'll be bringing from the hours and hotel Pharaoh's at my tail ring. When molded did, the Lord kept out his sin, plagues will lie without no Pharaoh's home to go and any him be. When he's all about with the top of the day, the fire will light, but look the way, no Pharaoh's son, but his eyes ain't getting by. He's getting rid of his son, with band, all the chariots throughout the land, now that the red light grows all the time.
He
saved
him from Pharaoh's evil hand. He
promised
to guide, kept him on
the
journey, and made him to the promised land.
When he came to the bank of those in blue, they turned over and said, what are we doing? Old Moses fell on his knees there in the sand. Now the Lord had Moses questioned God. All he got to do is get raised up by the Lord. Over that mighty water, step forward. Old Moses followed the Lord's command. The waters parted, and there in the sand, they saw the man that led to the other shore. When the ground was dry, they passed on through. Pharaoh had a thought they would do, but the one that fell ain't never been seen at all.
God comes to lead his children out of bondage. He said he'd free them from Pharaoh's evil hand. He comes to guide and take him on a journey and lead him to the promised land.
There's your first gospel rap. Hovey Lister and the Statesmen led out of bondage. Now, I'm going to show you something that is super duper cool. read some of these comments in a minute. This is this right here. Okay, so we got the vinyl, and this is the real vinyl. This isn't some kind of a remake, a redo deal, because inside is the original vinyl liner. And I want to show you this. This record was on Capitol Records. You say, if you're into music at all, you know what I mean when I say Capitol Records. If you're not into music, you don't have a clue. But everybody, whether you understand, been in music, not been in music, and Capitol Records, whether you know or don't know, you're going to appreciate this. So here's a Southern Gospel Quartet, Capitol Records. And I'm just going to first tell you a few of their label mates on Capitol, and then I'm going to show you this inside liner and just how cool this is. Here are some of their label mates. The Beatles, the Beach Boys, the Kingston Trio, Frankie Lane, Buck Owens, Sonny James, Wanda Jackson, Tennessee Ernie Ford, Charlie Louvin, Ferlin Husky, Nat King Cole, Nancy Wilson, Sammy Davis Jr., Wayne Newton, Peggy Lee, Judy Garland, Bing Crosby, and Frank Sinatra. Are you hearing me? Hovey Lister and the Statesmen on the same label with the Beatles and Frank Sinatra. What I'm trying to communicate to you, boys and girls, was back in the day, the music of Southern Gospel, well, it was kind of a big thing. Now, check out this inside liner. Right there is Nat King Cole, Sammy Davis Jr. You think I'm kidding? And this is the album liner. So how about this for just a great piece of memorabilia tonight? I'm bringing you some great memorabilia right here to you in living color. You're old if you know what I mean by when I say living color. Frank Sinatra. The Beatles. Beach Boys. The Letterman. And Hovey Lister and the Statesmen. What about that? Wow. And again, I say, wow. Okay, before we do the next question. Now, we could finish, I could stop the show now, and you know this has been a cool show. Right, if I stopped right now, I'm going to keep bringing it to you. Let's see who else is on here. We got Chuck Robbins. Terry Willett, oh, you're old if you heard this in person. I did. So did I. Paul Hyde says, many folks don't know this, but I was raised Catholic, was saved in 73, and that was when I started following gospel music. What about that, Paul Hyde? I didn't know that. Hello, Donald. Hello, Jacob. Hello, Isaac. Good evening. Terry Willits, I was a member of the Capitol Record Club. Now, that's cool. Now, I was a member of the Canaan Record Club, but I was not a member of the Capitol Record Club, Terry. You one-up me in the cool category there. Okay, here we go. Here's question number two. Again, tonight we're doing the flashback card series from the Singing News Magazine. And here is question number two. This is another super easy one. When did the Blackwood Brothers experience their terrible plane crash? Man, this is a cool show tonight because you're getting ready to love what I'm getting ready to play here. Was it 1944, 1954, 1964? And where did it occur? So let's start with when did the Blackwood Brothers experience the terrible plane crash? 44, 54, or 64? Come on, Terry. Don't make me wait all night. I want to play some of this music. 54. Thank you, Paul. And was it in Rome, Georgia, Austin, Texas, Clanton, Alabama? This is so easy. Come on, boys. Come on now. I went to the spot where the plane crash happened and saw the memorial that they did there. It was really cool. Matter of fact, I should have had that for this show. I've got my picture somewhere with that. Jacob, you're close. There you go. You got Clanton. You went from Clinton, Tennessee to Clanton, Alabama. But that's it. Clanton, Alabama, 1954. Now, okay, I'm getting ready to play something that's just cool. Now, this is bad audio, so you just got to deal with that. But there you go. No, it wasn't Mississippi. It was Alabama. Look at this. 1954, the final curtain, the original Blackwood Brothers Quartet, live in concert, Gulfport, Mississippi, June 29th, Tuesday, June 29th. The very next day at 7 p.m. at dusk, there was a tragic plane crash in Clanton, Alabama, there at the Alabama State Peach Festival. And Bill Lyles and R.W. Blackwood died in that plane crash. And this is the concert that was crudely recorded the night before. This is a cool show tonight. Y'all need to hit, what do you call that? Share. And let other people catch this show later. Okay, I'm going to play, let's see. I'm just going to play the very first cut. Again, this audio is not good audio, okay? So, just deal with that. But, it may not be great sounding audio, but it sure is cool. Last night before the plane crash in Mississippi.
All right, we're ready to go. We want to open our program tonight with one of our favorite gospel songs. We hope you'll enjoy it as we sing, Hide Me, Rock of Ages.
You know you love James. Listen to him talk. Here's a picture of them the night before the plane crash. Okay, and by the way, that was, you know, five decades before auto-tuning, auto-correct, editing, tuning, aligning, and this was recorded on, I think, like a Wallensack reel-to-reel. because it wasn't professionally recorded, although the audio didn't sound as bad as I thought it might sound. And boys and girls, that's singing. You just heard singing right there. Real singing, Hyde B. Rock of Ages. And again, this is on the album 1954, The Final Curtain Call, or The Final Curtain, the original Blackwood Brothers, live in concert, Gulfport, Mississippi, Tuesday, June 29th, 22 hours after they sang that song right there, two of the four men were dead in a plane crash in Clanton, Alabama at the Peach Festival that very next night, Wednesday, June 30th in Clanton, Alabama. And this picture, again, was taken the night before the plane crash. Wow. This is a good, good program tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Wow. Okay, so if it's not enough that I've got these two great old pieces of vinyl for the memorabilia tonight, and then the inside liner with all the Capitol records here for the Statesmen, and the last concert by the Blackwood Brothers that had Bill Lyles and R.W. Blackwood, if that's not enough, I'm going to show you a Polaroid picture that I own, that's mine, of the Blackwood Brothers. This was, let me see what it says. You know how it says the date on the thing? May 1955. This is 65 years old. And it's part of my personal collection. The Blackwood Brothers. Bill Shaw, J.D., James, Cecil. Right there is just some memorabilia. This is a great show tonight. Even Terry Willett says it is. Okay, we're down to the last question because I know everybody's getting ready for the big debate. Are you getting ready to pop some popcorn and just have a big time watching this debate between Donald Trump and the other guy, whatever his name is? Are you going to watch that? Let's see who's on here with us before I go to the third and final question. Paul, and everybody's trying to think of the year, and Clinton and everything. There's Jacob, and there's Terry, and Paul again. And Bill Lyles, are you watching? Roy Walls, hello? Is Peace Like a River on that album? Well, I don't know. Let me just tell you. It is not. And chatted with Bill Lyles and Barbara Blackwood Childs on Facebook today. Very cool, Terry. Man, share this program with them. Just hit the share button and send it to them in an instant messenger or something. Okay? Ricky Patterson, good to see you. Terry, great program. Thank you, sir. 20 millimeter photo. Yeah, I guess that's what that is. I'm not into that. I just know I own it and it's mine. All right. Okay, so here we are, the third and final question. We will play another song. Okay, we're getting into the 90s now with this one. The third and final question on this flashback card right here, the Singing News Magazine, the trivia questions, says this. Here I am, Milk and Honey, one more time, and mention my name. Which song did not reach the number one spot, and who recorded them? The clock is running. Go. Here I am. Milk and Honey. This is so easy. Milk and Honey, one more time. Mention my name. Which one did not go number one in the Singing News? And who was the artist that recorded all of those songs? The track of Here I Am is one of the greatest, most, one of the best sonic recordings I've ever heard in my life. I mean, it's incredible. Which one didn't go number one? Jacob Cash. I'm not old enough to know that. Well, you need to tune in every night to Facebook Live with Les and Jacob. You will learn stuff. And then you too can be an old man like your old buddy Les. All right, come on now. Here I am, Milk and Honey. One more time, mention my name. Which one did not go number one and who is the artist? Oh, I cannot believe nobody's jumping in on this. Isaac Hughes, are you still on here? You should know this. Come on, Isaac. You're letting me down, Isaac. Two of the members are in the Southern Gospel Music Hall of Fame, and they are a husband and wife. Paul Hyde says, the Clueless Quartet. No, it's not the Clueless Quartet. Oh, I can't believe this. Three of these four songs were Singing News number ones, and they were all big number ones. I mean, they were legit number one songs. And mixed family group, the mom and dad are in the Southern Gospel Music Hall of Fame. The group is in the GMA, the Gospel Music Hall of Fame. Okay, I'm going to give you the moniker by which they're known. America's first family of Southern Gospel music. I believe in this. The patriarch of the group has his own chocolate candy that he sells. I can't give you any more. Thank you, Terry. Whew. Really? The Hoppers. Now, which song was not number one? Here I am, Milk and Honey, one more time, mention my name. Which one? Which one? All right. I'm just going to have to tell you. You're letting me down. Terry, you're stepping up with the group, but no. Y'all are letting me down. The song that did not reach number one and got up to number four in the Singing News magazine is a song called One More Time. Now, what I am going to do is I am going to play one of the number one songs. I'm going to play one of the number one songs that we just talked about from the Hoppers. I am going to play, and by the way, this album here, I'll show it to you more here in a minute, has two number one songs on it. That's kind of a big deal. Any number one song is a big deal, but having two on one record, that's pretty good. So here's what I'm going to do. I am going to play the Hoppers' number one song that's called Mention My Name. Then after that, we're going to have a little bit different ministry moment. And then we're going to go watch a debate. Well, it says it's cut number nine. I don't know if this is it or not. I don't remember this intro if it is.
Would you mention
there it is.
My name every day when you pray? Would you mention my name? Diamonds or pearls.
Christian can pull a man through.
How many know that's true?
When he's facing this world that's so untrue. So if you want to help someone gain victory, well, don't forget where you plead to make mention of me. If I would request, oh, I do.
Songs and the third and final trivia question in Facebook Live with Les tonight. And man, we've had a good one with that Blackwood Brother and the Statesmen stuff and all that, all the additional, the extra picture and that liner and Capitol Records and just all of that. And the last concert of the Blackwood Brothers that included R.W. Blackwood and Bill Lyles. 22 hours later, they went home to be with the Lord. Wow. And got that music just to play for you tonight. And part of the trivia quiz there on the Singing News Flashback Card Series. I hope you enjoyed that one tonight. Man, that was really just, this one was a special one tonight. It really was. It was very good. Now, here's the ministry part. Here's what I want to end tonight with this. We're going to take the Hopper song there, Mention My Name. And I want you to go ahead right there and just type in. Maybe you don't want to say the name because you don't want to embarrass them if they should happen to stumble upon this program or something. But if you want to say the name of somebody that you're praying for that needs prayer, if you need prayer, you can put their initials, you can put your name, their name, well, however you want to do it. But type it in there, and I want us all just to take these names that you're going to see and even some unspoken requests and pray for them. Just like that song said, mention my name every day when you pray. Mention my name when you pray. When you're down on your knees, call on him, please. When you remember, please just mention my name. And man, the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Prayer really can move mountains and change things. And so we need to pray. We need to pray earnestly and fervently. And so if you have anybody that you want to throw in there, if it's you, if it's others, if it's neighbors, friends, loved ones, relatives, go ahead and type them in there. And we will jointly, I want all of you to maybe jot these down or something and pray for them this week, okay? There's Johnny, okay? Jimmy Hayes is saying, Johnny, we will pray for Johnny. Thank you, Jimmy. And I've got multiple unspoken requests and some that are spoken. My wife, Bev, always dealing with many multiple health issues. And so I always need prayer for her. Terry is saying, Terry, yes, sir, you got it. Chuck is saying, Stacy Robbins, yes, you bet. We will pray. We will pray for those folks right there. Always pray for my wife. Always pray for my children. And just pray for my family. Pray for me. I would appreciate it very much, for sure. We've got, and I've got a prayer list. A good thing for you to do. I know it's helped me greatly. I've got it in my phone. I've got a prayer list. I type the names of everybody that that I know of that has a prayer request, that needs prayer for something. And every day, I open that up and I pray for that prayer list, every name by name. I just don't say, Lord, bless this prayer list. I, as the song says, mention their names. And so I do that. And I recommend you doing that. You don't have to put it in your phone. It's just easier. You know, these days, that kind of thing is easy. If you want to jot it down, just keep a prayer list on a pad of paper and just keep filling it up. And I tell you what I like to do, like I did today. I got to take one of the names off. Now, sometimes I take a name off because the Lord has called somebody home. But I got to take a name off of a friend of mine who I've been praying that's had bad, bad, bad back pains and ended up has had multiple surgeries. I mean, it's bad stuff. And the last surgery worked, and we went to lunch today, and he is just whistling a tune. I mean, God has just showed up and touched him, whether it was a supernatural touch or whether it was God blessing that surgeon to do this surgery just the right way this time and to do everything just right. But I'm just telling you, God got in the middle of it, and my friend Tim Rabin was giving thanks to the Lord today at lunch. And so and I showed him, I pulled up my phone. I said, see my prayer list. And I went down and I said, there's your name. Watch this. Delete. And it's always a great thing when I can delete from the prayer list when God shows up and does something. And so you need to keep a prayer list is what I'm saying. Okay. Patty Graham says, my youngest son, Ian. Patty, be honored to pray for Ian. For sure. Excuse me. My Aunt Sue says her family, you know, we pray for them, Sue, and we will continue to do that. And Chuck says, Stacy Robbins, Terry, we'll pray for you. We will pray for Johnny. And anybody else here in the next minute or so, if you want to put any names down, we're all going to just jot these down and keep these names handy. And we're going to pray for them in these upcoming days. Okay. Matter of fact, I'll just pray right now, and then we will call it a night, and then let's go watch a debate and have some fun. What do you say? But first, we will pray. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity that we have to come to you. And as the song just said, we can mention names in prayer, Lord, and we know that when we mention them, that you hear them. And Lord, we know that not only that you hear them, but God, whatever the request is, whatever the question is, whatever the problem is, Lord, You can fix it. You can answer it. You can take care of it. And we're so glad that we can come to you with our problems, with our cares, with our concerns, God, and just lay them at your feet, knowing that you love us, you love your children. And you said to knock and to ask, and that's what we're doing. We're seeking, we're asking, we're knocking on behalf of these folks tonight. And so, Lord, I pray that you would be with Ian Patty Graham's youngest son. God, whatever the situation is there, you know what it is. Just intervene and get in the middle of that, Lord. I pray for my Aunt Sue, God, and her family. I pray, Lord, that you would do great and mighty things there and save the lost and direct their family, lead, guide, and direct them, Lord, and bless them and help them, I pray. I pray for Stacy Robbins. Don't know the situation there. Whatever it is, God, again, you do. I pray, Lord, that you would just intervene and help in that situation. Be with our friend Terry Willits, God. Just touch him, help him, bless him. Whatever the issue is, the problem is, the question is, Lord, we just pray that you would help him. And Jimmy Hayes has mentioned Johnny. I pray, God, that you would be with Johnny, whatever that situation is, Lord. And just get in the middle of it, intervene, take care of it, fix it, God, and we'll give you the glory and honor for all of it. And Lord, I pray as we get ready to watch this debate, Lord, I pray, God, that you would bless the candidate that is standing with Israel. You would bless the candidate that stands for freedom of religion and for essential for churches being essential and opening churches, God. And Lord, we know who that candidate is. And God, I pray for 4 more years. Lord, please get in the middle of this election, God, and do something big and mighty, and we will give you the glory and the honor for all of it. We love you, Lord. Thank you for this time together. We ask these things in your name. Amen. Well, amen. There you are. Facebook Live with Les. And man, if you missed it, you got to go back and watch this. I mean, I'll give you a little teaser here at the end. We played the last concert of the Blackwood Brothers before the plane crashed. That happened 22 hours after the song that I played. Played an old Statesmen song from Capitol Records and showed you the liner that had showed their label mates, folks like Frank Sinatra, Buck Owens, the Beatles, and so forth. That's right, a Southern Gospel quartet with label mates in the world like that on Capitol Records. It was kind of a big deal. And I showed a picture that I had of the Blackwood Brothers from 19, that I have, not had, I have, it's mine, from 1955, a Polaroid. Here, I'll show you again, just real quick. There you go. There it is right there. No, I got to put it away because I want you to go back and watch it, okay? And it was a great show. You need to share this with folks, okay? And Lord willing, we will see you, Thursday night. 7 Central, 8 Eastern, I'm going to be with Don Reed of the Statler Brothers right here on this Facebook page. The first of a 7-part series, and after that first show, I'm going to be coming right back at you with the Facebook Live playing the music of the Statler Brothers. Pretty cool stuff. Some great gospel music that they have produced throughout the years. And so that is Thursday night, 7 Central, 8 Eastern. God bless you. Lord willing, we will see you then.